G'day all, Mr. Paladin here with my top 10 things every Team Fortress 2 player needs to learn. I've been in a couple of games recently where there's just been players that have been so derpy I have no idea why they don't know these things. Okay, first thing you need to know is how each class aims and how it deals damage. Each class is vitally different from the others, and it's what makes this game one of the most wonderful mods ever made for Quake originally and then for Half-Life, etc., etc., when Valve purchased it. Each of the class does damage differently. Some of them don't do damage at all. Some are supporting other things. And you know, Spy. I do a lot of Spy. So let's look at some of the damage. First of all, you've got projectiles. You know, you fire it, it takes several seconds before it hits. Splash damage, stuff like that. But you've also got hit scan weapons where as soon as you shoot, you see those bullet holes? As soon as you shoot, the server determines what you hit. So those weapons are much better for hitting fast things like scouts. You have other classes that deal arced damage, arcing weapons. Or if you hold it down, you can shoot more accurately. I'm aiming at the top of that pole. And if you don't use them right, well, you're gonna die. After you learn the basics of each class, next you're gonna have to learn about their loadouts and how they change the class that you are using. Like, for example, the stock weapons for the scout are the pistol, the scattergun, and the bat. And he does really well with this. But if you change the pistol out for a bonk atomic punch, say you're coming up against sentries, you'll be able to distract it for the team. Or maybe you want to use a babyface blaster and you're going to load it up with a criticola so it does damage to get you up to speed faster. Or maybe you want the pocket boy's pistol, the force of nature to help your jumps, or you know, anything. It all changes. The Sandman with the guillotine, it does a long range damage and you don't want to get too close to people. You know, this all changes up the class, and for a new player this is going to be very overwhelming. I remember when I first jumped into Team Fortress 2, there were so many weapons I didn't know what each did. I didn't know, you know, the degreaser, flare gun, pyro, lots of damage. This is great, but maybe you just want to spread around the flames, so you go for a phlogistonator and scorch shot and the back scratcher to help your healing. This is a fine loadout, but let's say you're coming up against another pyro. You don't want this loadout at all. It's going to be useless against another pyro. You'd want to go maybe something like a back burner and the shotgun with the power jack. This might be a much better loadout for a pyro versus a pyro. So jump on the wiki, play around with your loadouts, play around with your weapons, and see how they alter the classes you are playing. Next thing you want to learn is about class stacking. The maps that you play in Team Fortress 2 are balanced for 24 players. That means 12 players on a team, and with 9 different classes, if you have more than 2 of any one class, you are going to miss something. You see here, this team, they're missing a medic, they've not got much offense, very defensive, very susceptible to spies with the engineers and the snipers. Next thing you want to learn, avoiding damage. I'm playing around with Voss here, I see that he's a demo man. And I'm just going to try to pick some damage on him while trying to avoid damage myself. I know he's going to want me near surfaces and stuff, so I'm jumping around off the edge where he can't hit me. Again, I'm looking around for him. This time he's a soldier. I'm not much of a match in those narrow corridors for a soldier. So I try and get away, see if I can come at a different angle, but he's hawking that health pack here. Ow, one damage. I know if I can come down here, he won't be able to hit me in time, and I've got a health pack back here. So avoiding damage helps you stay alive longer. If you've got a team working with you, not just doing one-on-one like we are here, then, you know, a little bit of damage you can do and get away and heal is going to help your team. You don't have so many teammates spawning all the time. You're able to stay at the front lines. Let's see, where is he? Gonna see if I can get him to damage himself with a bit of bonk, but no, he stops firing. He knows what I'm up to. The little face. Okay, I was on the capture point, so I knew I was over that direction. Sure enough, he goes scouting it. I'm out of there before his rocket hits. Remember, as we said before, understanding the loadout, understanding how he's going to be trying to deal damage to me. Oh, I didn't know how he knew I was there! But fortunately, I went up here, hooked the health pack. He went to shotgun, which we know is a hit scan weapon. Probably better for taking out a scout. Oh, buddy's rocket knocked me up in the air. Good job, good job. Let's see, coming back at him as a pyro, he is soldier. I know he's going to want to get to a health pack to stop the burn damage, but I'm going to keep burning him and keeping him away from the health pack. See, I'm looking for him. I see that slight bit of damage indicator that came up from this corner? That's how I knew he was there, and I went after the health pack. Next, Ubers and Uber types and when and how to use them. This is a straight up Uber here, and you see I'm using it, and he went straight for the enemy medic, which was great. I stood on the cart to stop it moving forward. Next we have a Kritzkrieg. Kritzkrieg is much better on splash damage weapons. Look at that, 300, 200 damages. Ugh, that's nasty. See, we did this a couple times in this fight. Able to build Ubo really fast. Kaboom. No problem defending with a Kritzkrieg. Just using the Ubo correctly. Don't force anything. Help your guy out. Give it to him at the right time. And the quick fix. Quick fix is good if the enemy teams are using pyros. You'll be able to get past their air blast, but I'm going to hook up with a scout here. He's using the babyface blaster, so we're running extremely fast. Even if people hit us, we're able to heal up fast enough and just go wherever we want. There's no sentries around here, nothing stopping us. I'm just watching for where he's going. As soon as I lose contact with that beam, I slow down. So he's watching out for it. Whoa, this soldier. Really? Ow! Those almost died there. Ooh, I'm really low on health. Whoa. Going back to avoiding the damage. I'm burning, I'm hurt. I'm getting to the cart, getting a bit of a heal. My Uber's close, and as soon as I Uber, healed up. So yeah. Using the right Uber and knowing how to use the Uber that is given to you. Very vital to learn. Next thing to learn is that you do not need an Uber in order to break apart a defense. Especially to kill a sentry gun. Using the right class, the right position on the map, you can devastate a whole lot. I mean, I know they've introduced a short circuit which stops a demoman's effectiveness on sentry positions, and that might get changed soon. But, you know, you don't have to be a demoman either. A couple of classes can take out sentry guns in different ways. Oh, I don't think that was a headshot. I moved out of the way of that. Oh, damaged myself there. Had to get away from that spoo. Let's go back to wrecking those positions. Rather protected up here. I think I saw a spy there. I don't know where he went. Saw stickies above the payload. Of course I'd get a critical when I'm trying to destroy some stickies, you know. Have another go at those sentry positions. But I think we're okay to move in real soon. I mean, I don't see any sentries. Oh, that was a spy. Why on the cart? Had to come back later, team was still having trouble pushing forward. But again, no Uber, have no medic either. Ah, I felt that sentry gun. There we go. I don't know why I'm harping on this so much. I guess I'm just tired of teams that are too afraid to attack until they have a medic with them or until someone else has stepped up. I mean, just man up, get in there. Saw a spy behind the cart there. Get in there, get into a good position, fire down, get at the defenses, whatever. Do what you can. If you do what you can and the next guy does what he can and everybody does what they can, then you cap the thing in. You do not need an Uber to take out a defense. Okay, next. You need to assist your teammates. Teleporters are very important. We had a situation here where we got a teleporter into a very unusual position for a teleporter. You usually wouldn't put one this aggressive, but because we had one this aggressive, we're going to work together and use it. You'll see Vus here has come in as an engineer. I'm in communication with him. We're staying close together. Oh, let's get rid of that. Oh, saw a sniper dot on my sentry gun. I've got to watch it because with the rescue ranger, I'm actually taking mini crits if I'm walking around with that thing. Okay, I'm saying, okay, Vus, let's do this. We're moving it out. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Here we go. Now the combination of this teleporter and the pushed up sentry. You see how quickly my teammates are coming back to this spot? It doesn't take long till teamwork like this just wins the fight. Flashing up the scoreboard there just so I can see what enemies are still alive. Ow, 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 ow. But I'm getting a heal. How many of them are dead? A lot of them are dead. Can we push in? Come on team, can we push in? I'm trying to tell them. Teleporters are extremely important. If you're an enemy spy, it's almost more important to take out the teleport than it is to take out the sentry gun. As you saw in the last bit, if you're doing the tip previous to this, the sentry gun alone is not a problem. Get those teleporters down. It's just a game of attrition. Coming in at number 8. I think you need to have some map knowledge. You need to know where all the health packs are, where the ammo packs are, and what routes and what jumps you can take. So for example, we are going to use our knowledge of this map to get up here. The enemy team doesn't even look up here. We're having fun. We're saying, hey, we can go down, we can pick up extra ammo, no problem. Let's just take turns at this. Kill that soldier. Get his weapon. No problem. Just knowing a few tricks about the map or having experience on the map is good. What you might want to do is, I don't know, jump around them in offline, see where you can get to with your different rocket jumps, your sticky jumps. Practice your rocket jump and your sticky jumping. Oh, that was a nasty critical right into spawn. Now, I don't blame any of this on an offensive team or a defensive team. This is completely on the map maker. If the map maker lets me do any of this, then I'm sorry, offense and defense. It's up to you to know it and to work out how to stop it. None of this was unstoppable. I'm looking for ammo now. The demo man picked up that one. I'm trying to avoid the stickies. Oh! Vus bit the bullet there. Couple of jumps. I'm in places where people aren't expecting me to be. I get a few free shots in. I see the medic. Come back for this health pack. Pick up the weapon. having to spam the beggars every now and then so I don't overload it on myself. Just watching for that scout where he could jump to. Ooh, I really need healing. I've got to stop this spike. Don't know if he was dead ringer. I'll check the corner. There's a medic. Thank you. You know, a bit of map knowledge goes a long way. Combine it with the other tips that we've already covered about knowing your weapon, about knowing the loadouts of the other team, you can do wonders. That looked like a spy there. I think the demo man got him. I'm watching that mini sentry even though there's a soldier out to my right. Gonna fall back to the health pack, but it was already taken, so I'm hoping this medic will help me, and yes he does. And he's fully charged, so I go running in, and he didn't Uber me. What a mean medic. Took a bit of damage. But later in the same round, you know, we're putting everything together now. Advanced teamwork. Use all the tips we've already said, not only in yourself, but your teammates are using them. This is the final thing I want people to do. All these things, all the time, every team, every game you play, working together. So for example, here I've switched out to be a quick fix medic. I'm working with Vus. We're using our knowledge of the map and our rocket jumps to get into really strange places. This is the same round where I was just the beggar's bazooka soldier. Got Uber charge ready. I know how to use the Uber charge. He knows how to use my Uber charge once he gets it. He knows we're going to take out that pyro, no problem. He knows the teleporter is important, he goes for that next. Don't know if that was a friendly spy or not. I could have popped a heal to it, but spies generally don't like the heals. They can go to health packs in plenty of places. I saw the pyro coming, I told Vus, hey, there's a pyro. No problem, we're falling back. I see that Vus dies. So I get the heck out of there using my map knowledge. I know where I can fall to, I know where I can fall back to. I saw a critical sticky land next to me. I knew there was a demo man up there, I avoided it. Got the assist from the sniper who also saw the target. Beautiful, teams working together. Saw a sniper die in front of me, I know there's a soldier above the spawn, I'm letting my team know. Vus comes out, checks it out. I think he's already dead by the time we get here. But again, using the quick fix and rocket jumping to get back over here. Wunderbar. When stuff like this happens in game, this is what makes this game better than other games, when things are just clicking all together. I see the medic's getting damaged, I fall back to him. Ugh. Vus died, but I knew I could fall back. I knew where to fall back to, I could run this map backwards. Trying to get a heal to that sniper before he had to come back all the way. 12 seconds left, 10 seconds left, I'm checking the payload, making sure all our guys are good here. I don't want to heal the same heal target as that other medic, but there was no one else around. And that's the way you do it. Okay, and final tip, it should actually be tip number one, but my final tip is... play the objective. It's Team Fortress 2, not Solo Deathmatch 2. I don't care if you die a billion times before you cap that payload or you cap that capture point. Play Team Fortress with your team and play the objective of the map. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.